This video is prepared by Avya Classes. Please subscribe the channel, raise your doubt and watch the video for sure success in JEE, AIIMS and NEET.
Hello friends, now we will discuss inelastic collision. So what is inelastic collision? When after the collision both body moves independently but there is a loss of kinetic energy also associated, then we call it inelastic collision. So consider the figure given here. Here the mass m1 is moving with a velocity u1 and m2 with velocity u2. After collision the both body will move, or the m1 will move with velocity v1 and m2 with v2. So if it would be a perfectly elastic collision, then there must not be any loss of kinetic energy. So as there is a loss of kinetic energy, it means it's not a perfectly elastic collision or a elastic collision. Now if both body moves together, or if after the collision they stick to each other and move together, then it must be a perfectly inelastic collision. So it's this type of collision lies in between perfectly elastic and perfectly inelastic collision. So we may say that if we consider that this type of collision lies between perfectly elastic, in fact perfectly inelastic and elastic collision. So there is a loss of kinetic energy associated with this kind of collision. However, both body moves independently, unlike a perfectly inelastic collision. So because of this, the coefficient of restitution of inelastic collision lies between 0 and 1. 0 is the coefficient of restitution, as we have already learned, it's a relative velocity of separation divided by relative velocity of approach. So if you consider this figure, then after collision the velocity of separation or the relative velocity of separation will be v2 minus v1, while before collision the relative velocity of approach will be u1 minus u2. So clearly, in case of perfectly elastic collision, the both body moves independently, and we may say that there is no loss of kinetic energy. So in case of perfectly elastic collision, the coefficient of restitution will be 1, while in case of perfectly inelastic collision, the coefficient of restitution will be 0. In case of inelastic collision, the coefficient of restitution lies between these two terms, 0 and 1. So it's written here for inelastic collision, E lies between 0 and 1. So V2 minus V1 is equal to E into U1 minus U2. So if we apply this, if you just multiply U1 minus U2 with E, we get this formula. So most collision in the world lies in this category. Now we will consider the head-on elastic collision in detail. So we will try to derive out the formula of velocity in case of head-on elastic collision. So if you consider this figure, then velocity of two bodies after the collision will be v1 and v2 respectively, and if the coefficient of restitution is E, then we may get two formula, one formula based on the coefficient of restitution and another formula based on the conservation of linear momentum. So the formula based on coefficient of restitution will be v2 minus v1 is equal to E into u1 minus u2. You just remember this formula, or if you don't want to remember, you can derive this formula directly from this figure. And you may recall also this fact that if I put E is equal to 1, then we get the formula for elastic collision, while if I put the value of E is equal to 0, we get the formula for perfectly inelastic collision. I just show you here also that for E is equal to 1, we get V2 minus V1 is equal to U1 minus U2, and it was for elastic collision, or we may also say it perfectly elastic collision. And E is equal to 0 implies that V2 minus V1 is equal to 0, and its V1 is equal to V2. So in case of elastic collision, it's V2 minus V1 is equal to U1 minus U2, while in case of perfectly inelastic collision, it's V1 is equal to V2, or both body stick to each other and then move. So now it's our second formula is the law of conservation of linear momentum, and as per this law, the initial momentum is equal to final momentum as collision is a internal, or there is a no external force associated in collision. So if you see this figure and then write the conservation of linear momentum, then the initial momentum will be equal to m1 u1 plus m2 u2, as both body are moving in same direction, and we consider the direction of positive x in this way, then m1 u1 comes with a positive sign and m2 u2 comes also with a positive sign. So the net momentum is equal to m1 u1 plus m2 u2. And if you consider the momentum after collision, then again it's m1 v1 plus m2 v2. So as per the law of conservation of momentum, we get this equation number 2. Now we have two equations. First equation is the equation based on the coefficient of restitution, and another is based on the conservation of linear momentum. And so if we solve these two equations, first we will try to get the value of v1. So as we have equation 2 here, and equation 1 is equal to v2 minus v1 is equal to e u1 minus u2, and from there v2 is equal to e u1 minus u2 plus v1. Now you have to calculate v1 first, so you have to eliminate v2 from equation 1 and 2. So from equation 2, it's m2 v2 is equal to m1 u1 plus m2 u2 minus m1 v1. Now put the value of v2 in this to get. So m2 v2 is e u1 minus u2 plus m2 v1 is equal to m1 u1 plus m2 u2 minus m1 v1. Now take v1 on one side, then you get m1 plus m2 v1 is equal to, take u1 common, then m1 minus e m2 plus u2 into m2 plus e m2. And if you solve it, then you get v1 is equal to m1 minus e m2 u1 divided by m1 plus m2 plus m2 1 plus e u2 divided by m1 plus m2. So this is the value of v1. Similarly, you can calculate the value of v2. So for calculating this, you just use the formula that v2 is equal to v1 plus e u1 minus u2, and if you put the value of v1, that is m1 minus e m2 u1 divided by m1 plus m2 plus m2 1 plus e u2 whole divided by m1 plus m2, then you get the value of v2. You will get is equal to 1 plus e m1 divided by m1 plus m2 u1 plus m2 minus e m1 divided by m1 plus m2 into u2. So in this way we can calculate the velocity v1 and v2 of the ball after collision. Now we will move to our next concept, and this is the loss in kinetic energy. So we have to calculate the loss in kinetic energy if the ball undergoing inelastic collision. So in case of inelastic collision, the loss of kinetic energy will become equal to 1 by 2 m1 m2 divided by m1 plus m2 1 minus e square u1 minus u2 whole square. So how we calculate this loss is equal to total initial kinetic energy minus total final kinetic energy. As we know that here the initial kinetic energy will be more than the final kinetic energy, and because of it we see the loss in kinetic energy. So if you substitute the value of v1 and v2 from the expression we have already calculated, then we get the formula of loss in kinetic energy. You just remember this formula, that the loss in kinetic energy is equal to delta k is equal to 1 by 2 m1 m2 divided by m1 plus m2 1 minus e square into u1 minus u2 whole square. Now if you put the value of e is equal to 1, then you can get the loss in kinetic energy due to or in elastic collision. So loss of kinetic energy in case of elastic collision or the perfectly elastic collision, e is equal to 1, and we get delta k is equal to 0. That is, there is no loss of kinetic energy associated in case of elastic collision, which we have already learned. So, and in case of perfectly inelastic collision, like in case of perfectly inelastic collision, E must be equal to 0 as the both body move simultaneously, and delta K is equal to 1 by 2 m1 m2 divided by m1 minus m2 into u1 minus u2 whole square. So it is quite clear that the loss in kinetic energy is maximum in case of perfectly inelastic collision, while in case of elastic collision it is 0, and in case of inelastic collision the loss in kinetic energy lies between these two types of collision. So these concepts about perfectly inelastic collision and elastic collision we have already completed. Now we will calculate the ratio of velocities after inelastic collision. So the figure is shown here. You have to calculate the ratio of velocity. Basically we are calculating the ratio of velocity in case of inelastic collision if both are having same mass and the other body is in rest. So the figure is given here. Both are having mass m1. The first mass is moving with a velocity equal to u, so we just write u1 is equal to u, and other body was stationary, so we write u2 is equal to 0. Now after, this is the case of before collision, and after collision the first body is moving with a velocity equal to v1, and other body moves with a velocity equal to v2. So basically in this case, how we'll calculate the value of v1 and v2? So again we will apply our two standard formula. First is the formula for coefficient of restitution, and other is the conservation of momentum. So here the formula for conservation of momentum is given. It's the easiest formula to apply. Initial momentum is equal to final momentum. In fact, total initial momentum is equal to total final momentum. So total initial momentum is equal to m into u, and total final momentum, if you see this figure, the momentum associated with this body is mu, for this body is 0, so total initial is mu plus 0 and it comes equal to mu, while in case of final momentum it's mv1 plus mv2. So we get v1 plus v2 is equal to u, and if we apply the formula of coefficient of restitution, then we get E is equal to velocity of separation divided by velocity of approach. Velocity of separation is equal to V2 minus V1. Velocity of approach is U. So we get V2 minus V1 divided by U is equal to E, and from there we get V2 minus V1 is equal to EU. So basically we have these two formula. If you add equation 1 and 2, you get the value of V1. So if you add V1 and V2, in fact you get the value of V2. So V1 plus V2 is equal to U, and V2 minus V1 is equal to EU. If you add, then V1 get cancelled and you get 2V2 is equal to EU plus U, and from there you get V2 is equal to U1 plus E by 2. So this is the formula of V2, and while in case of V1 is equal to V1 is equal to, you just subtract it. So from there, if you subtract 2 minus 1, so basically if you subtract 2 minus 1, you get 2V1 is equal to U minus EU, and from there you get V1 is equal to 1 minus EU by 2. So now if you come to this figure, then as per this figure, just remember that if it is coming with a initial velocity U strikes to a stationary body having same mass, then its velocity will be changed to 1 minus E by 2 into U, while the next body which was stationary earlier gains a velocity equal to 1 plus E into U by 2.